गुड इवनिंग. टुडे इज 5th of December 2020, फ्राइडे. वी आर प्रेजेंटिंग अ वाइटल टॉपिक फॉर कंपाइलर डिजाइन एज पार्ट ऑफ आर असाइनमेंट गिवन बाय प्रोफेसर सोमनाथ रॉय चौधरी. आर टॉपिक फॉर टुडे इज लेक्सिकल एनालिसिस एंड लेक्सिकल एनालाइजर जनरेटर, विच विल बी प्रेजेंटेड बाय अन्वेषा दे, रोल नंबर 125, एंड मायसेल्फ देवलीना गोस्वामी, रोल नंबर 107. सो लेट्स बिगिन. लेक्सिकल एनालिसिस. द स्कैनिंग और लेक्सिकल एनालिसिस फेज ऑफ अ कंपाइलर परफॉर्म्स द टास्क ऑफ रीडिंग द सोर्स प्रोग्राम एज अ फाइल ऑफ कैरेक्टर्स एंड डिवाइडिंग अप इनटू टोकन्स. Usually implemented as subroutine or co-subroutine of parser. It is also the front end of a compiler. Tokens, patterns, and lexemes. Token is a classification of lexical units, for example, ID and num. Lexemes are the specific character strings that make up a token, for example, ABC and 123. Patterns are rules describing the set of lexemes belonging to a token. For example, the letter followed by letters and digits and non-empty sequence of digits. Application. Scanners perform pattern matching process. The techniques used to implement lexical analyzers can also be applied to other areas such as query languages and information retrieval systems. Since pattern directed program is widely useful, pattern action language is also called LEX for specifying lexical analyzers. The LEX scanner generator. LEX is a scanner generator. Systematically, it translates regular definitions into C source code for efficient scanning. It also helps the generated code is easy to integrate in C applications. The next part will be taken by Anvesha De.
Looking at how to create a lexical analyzer with LEX. This is how a lexical analyzer is created. First, the LEX source program, here for example, we have given it the name lex.l. It goes into the LEX compiler as the input and we get the LEX C code. It generates a C code for us, which has been given the name lex.yy.c. That code is given in goes as an input into the C compiler and we get the output as a.out. Then when we put the input stream, that is our token sequence or our characters, into the a.out, we get the sequence of required tokens as our output. Then we have some regular expressions in LEX. For example, when we give x, it actually matches the character x. Here we, for example, here we have r1 r2, which will max which will first match r1 then r2, that is concatenation. Then r closure match zero or more occurrences. We also have r1 or r2, that is match r1 or r2. Like this only, we have several regular expressions in LEX which help us understand it better. Then we have here the design of a lexical analyzer generator. In a lexical analyzer generator, it first translates regular expressions to NFA, then it translates the NFA to an efficient DFA. The DFA part is actually optional. We can keep it till the NFA. If we want it if we want our output to be in the form of DFA, only then we will convert the NFA to DFA. That is why we have given the braces optional. Then we have non-deterministic finite automata. This has been given just to show what happens in an NFA, that is in a generator, when it converts into NFA. An NFA, that is the definition of NFAs, and NFA is a five tuple, where S is a finite set of states, alphabet is a finite set of input symbol alphabet. Then we have mapping from S to alphabet. Then S0 is the start state of S, and F is a set of accepting states, or the final state that we get as an output. Then transition graph. An NFA can be diagrammatically represented by a label directed graph called a transition graph. Here we have shown one example of a transition graph of NFA. Here 0, 1, 2 and 3 are the start states, that is S. Then as input states we have A and B. S0, that is the start state, is 0, and F is the final state, that is 3. Then this is a transition table. Transition table, what is the transition table? The mapping of an NFA can be represented in a transition table. For example, the previous transition graph has been given here as the transition table. How we will write in a transition table? That is, for state 0, input A we have 0, 1, and input B we have 0. For state 2, as input A, we have nothing because we didn't have any input A in state 2. But for input B, we are getting 3. Then this is the design of a lexical analyzer generator, that is from regular expression to NFA to DFA. Lex specification with regular expressions are given. The actions are given, pass, that is part 1, P1, action 1, P2, action 2, and hereby we have different actions. First, we have S0 as the start state. Every regular expression will provide one action, will be converted to one NFA, which will be further combined, and then we will get the DFA part, which is absolutely optional. If we want, only then we will convert it. Then here we have the gate questions, sir. The first two questions will be read by Deblina.
Thank you, Anvesha. So here we have our first question, which reads as, the number of tokens in the following C statement is printf, and here we can see which the statements are, and the options are as follows. Option A, 3, option B, 26, option C, 10, and option D, 21. And the answer is option C. The explanation being, in a C source program, the basic element recognized by the compiler is the token. A token is a source program text that the compiler does not break down into component elements. There are 6 types of C tokens: identifiers, keywords, constants, operators, string literals, and other separators. There are total 10 tokens in our previous question. Below are the tokens of the given statement, which is printf. And there here is the string statement, comma, I, then again a comma, the and operator, the I bracket, and then we have the full stop. Next question. Here is our second question. Consider the following statements. Statement 1, the output of a lexical analyzer is groups of characters. Second statement, total number of tokens in the statement printf, I is equals to percentage D, and I is equals to percentage X, comma I, comma and percentile I are 11. Symbol table can be implemented by using array and hash table, but not tree. Which of the following statements is or are correct? option A, only one, option B, only two and three, option C, all, which are option one, two and three are correct, and option D, none of the above. And the answer is option D. The explanation being, the output of a lexical analyzer is tokens. Total number of tokens in printf, I is equals to percentile D and percentile I is equals to percentile X comma I comma and percentile I are 10. Symbol table can be implemented by using array, hash table, tree and linked lists. So option D is correct. Next, I will hand over to Anvesha.
We have the third question, that is, if the lexical analyzer finds a lexeme with the same name as that of a reserved word, it fill in the blank. This question was asked in GATE 2001. The options are option A, overrides the word, option B, overrides the functionality, option C, generates an error, and option D, something else. The answer is option C, that is, it gives an error. The explanation being, reserved words are known as keywords and they are specific and reserved with its functionality to a language. Thus, getting an input with the same name by the analyzer will generate an error. Here we have the last question to our presentation. Which phase of compiler includes lexical analysis? GATE 2001 question. The options are option A, 1, option B, 2, option C, 3, and option D, it's a primary function, not in any phase. The answer is option A, 1. The explanation is, the first phase of compilation process is called lexical analysis. It fragments the source code into token, which is the smallest programming unit of a program. With this, we come to the end of our presentation. Thank you.
Thank you, Andisha, Deblina. Excellent presentation.